certainly knew what was in that bill long before the last pages were printed.
Well, you're saying that you knew what most of it was, but not necessarily the additions that were added to the bill in the last hour or two. I'm old enough to remember the 86 tax cut bill. It took 15 months. I'm just wondering, I mean, just as a simple yes or no, I mean, was this the process that you had hoped for, to have all these changes made at the last minute?
Well, Jake, I'll say it this way. The last hearing that we had was a 23-hour hearing. We had 63 Democrat amendments that were offered. The suggestion that this was not done in the light of day, and the last-minute changes as they talk about them were last-minute changes that had been envisioned for weeks. We knew at the end that there would be dials that were changed. So here's an example. We increased helping small businesses by about 2.4%. That happened in the last hour or so, but that had been envisioned for the last 10 days because we had been talking about that. So we had another amendment by Senator Rubio to increase the child tax credit. Had that happened on the floor, that would have been a last minute change, but that was something else that had been envisioned. So there were no new ideas, no new opportunities, simply opportunities that had been envisioned that were going to be voted yes or no on the floor and then fused into the final product. The suggestion that we had so little time to take a look at 500 pages is inconsistent with truth.
All right, Senator Tim Scott of South